I have just finished my lecture in Zoom and would like to create a list of all participants that were present in my Zoom meeting. So in this video, I will show you how you can export a list of all participants in a Zoom meeting from Zoom to an Excel sheet and get a list that looks like this, where I can see which of my students participated in today's seminar and also for how long they were participating. But in order to get to this list, you need to do some work with your data. So I will also show you how you, with a couple of really smart Excel functions like COUNTIF, VLOOKUP and IFERROR, do some Excel magic. So welcome to this short tutorial. The first thing I do is to sign in to my Zoom account. So I'm at Chalmers Zoom US. You are probably some other address, but I just click sign in. And now I'm signed in on my Zoom account in the web interface. And I go directly down to reports in the column to the left. Under usage report, I click usage. Here I can filter between what time I want to have different reports. Now I have filtered for just showing Zoom meetings for yesterday and today. So I have had one lecture here. And you can see what kind of information I have here. I have the duration in minutes. That could be interesting when you are checking your participant list, so you know if they were participating during the whole meeting or not. And then number of participants. So I click on number of participants. I click on show unique users to filter out the dublets and export meet with meeting data and click export. Now I have an Excel down in the left corner. I click open the file. So this is how the list looks like when you open it up in Excel. I have replaced some letters in the name so it becomes a bit more anonymous. But the list looks like this, and it's a CSV file. That means that each column is separated with a comma, and you need to fix this to make it more useful in Excel. I start with deleting the rows, so I select them, press delete. I start with selecting the first cell in my list, and then with Control Shift down arrow, I can select the whole column. So now the whole column is selected, and then I can separate each column that are comma separated by going to the data tab and choose text to columns. And as delimiter, I click next and choose comma. So now you will see how everything is separated into useful columns. Click on finish. So now I have a list with all participants in the list. But the next thing I would like to do is to check who was present and who was not. So I copy this list to another sheet that looks like this. In this sheet, I have all the name of all the participants in my whole class. And to the left, I have the one that was participating in this meeting. So in order to check if the name here is present in the participant list, I can use a lot of different functions. One thing I like to do is to use COUNTIF. So I type equal sign COUNTIF. There we have COUNTIF. And as range, I select the whole list of names in my participant list, starting with A5 in this case. So I select A5, Control Shift down arrow. So then I can select the whole list. I also press F4 to make this selection absolute. So I can copy it down. And then I separate to the next argument with a semicolon. In some languages, you separate with a comma, but in Sweden, you do it with a semicolon. And the criteria in this case, that's the cell to the right, that's K4. So then, and then I close the parentheses like this. And then I can copy this function to the last column in my list of all participants. I just double click in the bottom right corner of the cell like this. And now the formula is copied to the last row, as you can see. And what this say is that if there is a zero, then this person is not present in this list. So zero means that they were not present in at the seminar, and one was that they were. Of course, if I would like to add some more, like duration in minute, I can add duration like this and use like a X lookup or V lookup function if I use VLOOKUP. I do just type VLOOKUP like that. As lookup value, I choose the name, search for this name. As table array, I select from the name. So I select the whole range of participant list and press F4 to make this absolute. Semicolon for the third argument, column index, and in this case it's the third column that I want the data from, so I type a 3. And semicolon for the last argument if it should be an exact match or approximate match, but I would like to have an exact match, so I double click on false or type a 0. It's the same, but anyway, I close this parenthesis like that. Duration NA means that we can't find this name, and if there is not an NA, you get number of minute or the duration of minute when the person was there. If I don't want to have NA or just a blank cell, I can add an if error function before VLOOKUP. So before equal sign, I type if error like that. If error value, that's the VLOOKUP function, and semicolon, and then I type in whatever I would like to see if we can't find them. If I only want to have a blank cell if they are not present, then I just type 2 citation signs like that and close the parentheses like that. If we can't find them in the list, there will be a blank, and I double click it like that. So that is how you can get a participant list from a Zoom meeting and also use some Excel techniques to make it useful to filter out who was participating and how for how long. I hope this video will help you in your work. Thank you for watching.